and just using a permanent magnet. So they had this chariots where at the end of the chariot, the front, there used to be a person who used to point finger like this, and at the tip of the finger there used to be a magnet attached, and that person is free to, I mean, not the actual person, but small, you know, this thing. So he used to rotate like this freely. Okay, so he used to always, because the magnet is there, he used to always point in a particular direction. So if you have a dial like this, and the person is pointing finger in this direction, and you put a dial like this, 1, 2, 3 and 4, so you can navigate your entire army. You can say that to the army that you have to go in the direction of 2, fine? So they start moving, they rotate the chariot, so this dial rotates with the chariot. This is fixed, this direction is fixed, so as the chariot rotates, okay, this also rotates with the chariot, so it goes like this, okay? So now the person is moving in the direction of 2. So like this you should navigate the entire army. So they have won wars. So during less visible times when your enemy might not be able to move properly because the visibility is quite less, so they used to have food and they just enjoy it in that time. This emperor used to attack them to the tank because he has a navigation device. Okay, so he used to navigate his army properly and used to attack them. And also not just during land wars, in the sea, you might have seen the movie Titanic, right? So that ship already knew that they are going to collide with the iceberg, yes or no? 100 meters before itself, they know that they are going to collide it. But then they could not do anything about it. Why? Because it's not right, like riding a bicycle or riding a car on the road. You can't just turn quickly in the sea. So you have to be moving very, very precisely in the sea. And imagine there are thousands of the ship moving with you. Have you watched the movie 300? Troy? So there you have thousands of ships moving together. So if they are not aligned properly in a fixed direction, they will collide themselves. Yes or no? So that's the reason why a navigation device using a magnet navigation device is a great discovery of mankind. Alright? And then this was the only application of magnets for hundreds and hundreds of the years. Okay? People used to think that, you know, it always gets aligned in a particular direction because inside the earth there is a huge magnet. And magnet of the earth attracts the magnet, permanent magnet at hand, so that's why they get aligned in a particular direction. Okay? But later on they realize that there is nothing like that inside the earth. The magnetism of earth is because of something else. Okay, the molten lava is moving and the charges get generated. Because of that, the magnetism is that. But then that we are not going to learn right now. Okay, so this is the only application of magnet that was known for hundreds of the years. Then later on, you know, they understood that. Have you learned about magnetism class 10? Ostrad, have you heard of that name?
Yeah.
So he was conducting some experiments and he understood that magnetic field can be generated by just having a current in the wire. That's a great discovery. Why? That's a great discovery because first time you can, the current is because of the electric field inside the wire. Right? So using electric field or potential, you generated magnetic field. Okay, before that it was always a permanent magnet of the material used to generate a magnetic field. First then you have current generating the magnetic field. Okay, and on top of it, you know that if you have a loop like this, it creates magnetic field, let us say X. If you have to double the magnetic field, what you have to do? Either you double the current or you increase the number of turns. You take two turns. Magnetic field doubles. That's a great thing because of that you can increase the magnetic field without much of an effort. If you want to increase the potential difference, what you have to do? Have number of batteries. If you have 2 volt, and you want 10 volts, you should have 5 batteries connected in series. Okay? But if you have X amount of magnetic field, if you want to double it, just increase the number of turns. Okay? So that is why, you know, increasing magnetic field is very simple. Have you ever opened any electrical appliances and seen the windings? Multiple windings, wires are there. That is just to enhance the magnetic field. Okay? So enhancing magnetic field is very simple. Okay? Later on, Maxwell has proved that the electric field and magnetic field, they are just, two sides of the same coin. And as in, if you have one, you can generate, if you have electric field, you can generate magnetic field easily. And if you have magnetic field, you can generate electric field easily. Okay? And once that is found out, then there is no stopping. Because if you know how to convert magnetic field into electric field, then you can use the electric field to run the fans, lights, or whatever electrical appliances. Ideally, the current is because of electric field, right? So your appliances run on the current and electric field. So if you know a method to convert magnetic field into electric field or current, that's a great, great discovery. Okay? And even more so, you can increase the magnetic field easily. So if you increase the magnetic field easily and you have a method to convert magnetic field into electric field, it's a great discovery. And that discovery is generator. That's an AC generator, DC generator. Okay? Well, you have a magnet and a coil, you're converting your magnetic field into electric field using generators. Okay, so that's how the current usually gets generated when you convert magnetic field into electric field using generator. Okay? So that's why magnetic field or magnetism is important for us to study. Okay? And also, there are a lot of scientists who are doing research at the subatomic level. They are trying to find out what is the basic constituent of the substance. So initially when it all started, they thought that atom is indivisible. Atom is the smallest thing. Later on they understood that no, atom is not. Then they have coined electron, proton and neutron, these things. And then now they have came to an understanding that even that is divisible. How is that possible? They are trying to collide the subatomic particle. Then they're colliding, let's say, one electron with the other electron, and during the collision, if it breaks down and creates new particle, it means that it is not the smallest particle. Okay? So this collision should happen at a very high speed. And cyclotron is used to create such high speed. Cyclotron works on magnetic field. Okay? And there are various medical instruments that are made from, have you heard of MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, right? So we have a current inside our body. Every sense has a current. Like for example, if I'm touching this touch, why I'm feeling this touch? Because there's a current that goes in my brain, small current, that makes me feel the way it is. Fine? So there's essentially, so the current is flowing. Because of that current, there's a magnetic field also that gets generated. Every current has a magnetic field. So that magnetic field, when you put it in the image, okay, you'll be able to see the pattern of it. Fine? So I hope you understand the importance of magnetism. In fact, it is one thing where if magnetic field would not have been there, there will not be any AC or DC generator. Okay, we would be using batteries to run our fans and lights and all that. Okay, so this is the importance of magnetism. Now this chapter, how it is arranged, is like this. As the name suggests, this chapter is about study of moving charges and study of magnetism. Fine. But the problem with the way this chapter is arranged is like this. You are studying the behavior of moving charges inside a magnetic field without getting introduced to magnetic field first in your MCRT book. Okay? But how we will study this chapter is, first we will study magnetism, then we will study effect of magnetism on the moving charge. Understood? That's how it should be arranged. Okay, first you should know what is magnetic field, how to calculate magnetic field, and then look at how it can affect the motion of the charge. Like the way electrostatics was. In electrostatics, we had first got introduced to Coulomb's law, then electric field due to a single charge, then electric field due to a line of charge, circle of charge, like that we proceeded, right? Then towards the later part of the chapter, we got introduced to how the electric field can exert force on a charge, which is Q into E. Okay? Similarly, here also we should proceed like that. We should first understand how magnetic field gets generated, and then we will talk about how magnetic field affects the moving charge. Understood? Okay, now tell me, what is the basic cause of electric field? What causes the electric field? A charge. Simple. A charge causes the electric field. Any doubt? What causes magnetic field? What do you think causes the magnetic field? A moving charge. So when you have a permanent magnet, a bar magnet, where is the moving charge there? What is the basic cause of magnetic field? What it is? Have you heard of these things? North pole and south pole? So north and south pole creates magnetic field or not? Right? Now, can North Pole exist separately? South Pole can also not exist separately. But counterpart of a positive charge, you can say, is a North Pole. Counterpart of negative charge is South Pole, you can say that. But positive charge can exist separately, but a North Pole cannot exist separately. Getting it? So it's like positive and negative charge always exist together. So what is the basic cause of the magnetic field? A dipole. Dipole is the equal and opposite charge. Right? So the basic element of the magnetism is a dipole itself. Write down. There should be north and south pole. So the basic cause of magnetism is a dipole. Basic cause of magnetism is a dipole. What is this dipole? It's a magnetic dipole. It's not an electrostatic dipole. It's a magnetic dipole. In the bracket you write magnetic. Magnetic dipole. Okay? Now, there has to be a north pole and south pole. Then only magnetic field will be there. Okay? And if you have a loop, if you have a loop of current like this, where is north and south pole? Can you tell me? How the magnetic field lines will be? Coming out? Coming out? So this will be your north pole. This is your north pole. This is the north pole, okay, and behind is your south pole, okay. So even a current loop can be treated like a dipole. Understood? All of you? So a current loop can be treated like a dipole. Now we know that the smallest charge that exists in the world is what? Electron charge. Although that is not true now, because we know that E by 3 and 2E by 3 can also exist. But for the sake of this syllabus, we have this understanding that electron charge is the smallest charge. Okay? Now can you tell me